How to record Shopify sales in QuickBooks? There are two methods. First is manual journal entry method, and second is third-party integration method like A2X and other apps. Today we shall discuss first method, manual journal entry. What is journal entry method? We need to manually enter summarize some monthly transactions into QuickBooks. There is no need to use A2X or other any apps for integration. Merits: only one transactions need to record it per month. Good for small businesses where there are few transactions. Using few payment processors like Shopify payments in normal case. Demerits: timing difference between sales and payouts is occurred, then we need to record them in a clearing account. 7 steps to record sales, Shopify sales in QuickBooks. First step is identify payment processors, that is also called payment gateways, that are attached with our Shopify account and used to process the payments. Customers send the payment and we receive in our these gateways like Shopify payments, PayPal, Amazon Pay, FM Pay, Naya Pay. Second step is to set up chart of accounts in QuickBooks Online for these heads. There are 3 columns given in our snapshot. First one is account's name that needs to be created. The second column is account type. We need to record these heads under these category of heads like income, cost of goods sold and other current assets. The detail types, these are sub category of accounts, subhead of accounts. For example, you need to record Shopify sales in income category and select as a detail type sales of product income. Next, Shopify discount, it would be under income and their subcategory would be discount and refund given. And in this way, you shall record Shopify refunds, Shopify shipping income under income account. After that, you shall record material cost under cost of goods sold. You may rename them as a cost of goods sold, or you may write their name like a material cost. It would be heading of under cost of goods sold, and their detail type would be supplies and materials. Shopify fee could be part of cost of goods sold, and it depends upon your policy. You may charge as a processing fee or other fees. Inventory, these need to be recorded under balance sheet item. Their accounts type should be others current assets. Other account is Shopify pending balances. It would be also part of current assets. The last portion is Shopify gift card liabilities. It would be accounts type of other current liabilities, because these are liabilities we need to pay in future. Shopify sales tax collected on the sales, it would be the part of other current liabilities. Once we have set up chart of accounts in the QuickBooks, the next step is add clearing accounts for payment processors like Shopify payments, PayPal payments, Amazon Pay and FM Pay, Afterpay and the Klarna Pay. These are 3 columns in snapshot. For example, we need to create account for Shopify payments clearing. Their type, account type would be other current assets, and the detail type is also other current assets. It depends upon how much payment processor are you using for your Shopify sales. If you are using only one Shopify, then you shall need to create only Shopify payment clearing account. Or you are using more than one, like PayPal, Amazon, FM, then you shall need to create all these clearing account as well in the startup accounts. Next step is add accounts for payment processing fee in the QuickBooks Online. For example, you are using Shopify payments, Shopify accounts payment processor, then you shall create Shopify fee. And if you are using PayPal, then you shall create PayPal fees. And these would be the part of cost of goods sold. It depends upon your policy. If you categorize to another expenses, you may select the category other expenses. And the detail type would be the other cost of services. It would be the subheading, subclass of accounts. You shall create these processor fees in the chart of accounts as per your requirements. After creating it, we shall move forward to the Shopify sales center. Here we shall go to the left navigation bar. We shall go to the analytics. Under the analytics, there is a reports portion. You shall click it, and you will find finance summary on the right side, and then you shall select it. After clicking on the finance summary, this type of report shall be shown at your screen. At the right side, you shall select the dates, period for which you want to run this summary reports. In this example, I shall take last month sales for Shopify. So I selected last month, and this statement shall be shown here in the left side. These are all heads of sales. In the right side, these are the payment processor where we receive our payments. At the bottom left side, there is liability, gift card sales. And in the bottom right side, this is gross profit, net sales minus other expenses, cost of goods sold, and gross profit. This is not correct. Don't trust this. So we need to understand the sales heads. The first option is gross sales, and the second point is discount. Third is return, and the fourth one is net sale. This is sum of above three amounts, and the fourth one is shipping income, taxes we collected on the sales, and the total sales. This is basically breakup of all our sales. It's also showing our sales minus discount, minus returns, plus shipping charges, and plus taxes. Please remember that the taxes we collected on the Shopify sales are our liability, and we need to submit IRS or our tax regulatory body on the monthly or quarterly basis. At the bottom side, gift card sales. If there is any amount showing here, we need to record them. On the right side, there is payments processor. This is showing how many channels we used to collect our payments, which were sales on Shopify. quarter. So normally businesses use Shopify payment processor, but if you have already other type of facilities, you may attach them. For example, you collect the payment on the cash basis. This is manual 7 point, and the 8 point is PayPal standard. 9th is Shop Pay installment, and the 10th is Shopify payments. This is total of our payments. Okay, next step is record this sales in journal entry. We shall create our journal entry. We shall go to journals entry, add new, and this window shall be open, and we shall record all these heads, all these figures from finance summary to this journal entry. The first amount we shall record, that was gross sale, the 0.1. We shall record in Shopify sales in the 0.2, that was Shopify discount. This amount was negative, so we shall record in debit. The sales, gross sale was positive, and the sale is always credit nature, so we shall record on credit side. Discounts are like expenses, these are debit nature, we record them on debit side. And the Shopify returns sale, these are sale returns, these are reversal of our sales, so it could be recorded on debit side. The next one is our shipping income. This is income, so it would be recorded on credit side. And the other fifth option was sales tax. These were collected on the sales, so this is liability in nature, so we record them on credit side. And if there was any gift card liability amount, we shall record them on the credit side, if there was any amount. In our case, there is zero amount, so we shall not record it, just it is selected here for your reference. In the seventh, we shall record our Shopify clearing amounts. We receive payments in manual clearing, that was 8 to 1/8, and these would be the part of Shopify clearing account. We receive these payment, so these are assets and debit nature, so we record them on debit side. Next, we receive PayPal amount, we should record on debit side, and the Shop Pay, that was for on debit side, and the Shopify payment clearing, that is recorded on debit side. So there is difference. The debit side and credit side must be equal, but in our case it's not equal, so this is due to timing difference, so we record them as a Shopify clearing and 49.5. Make sure debit and credit side of journal entry must be equal. After that, click save and close. Our Shopify sales is recorded now in our QuickBooks Online. You may run profit and loss accounts, this report section, and you may see your latest journal entry in your profit and loss accounts for the given period. Please make sure that you should run the reports of profit and loss account as per the journal entry. For example, you recorded this sale in the month of August 31st, so it would be recorded in the August month, and you need to run your profit and loss account of August. So that's all for today. My name is Abid Hussain Malik from Abid Financials. I am CPA, chartered accountant, and have a more than 10 years of experience in accounting and bookkeeping of e-commerce. I am specialist in Shopify, Amazon, Walmart, eBay, and other areas of bookkeeping. If you have any problem, you may contact me at my WhatsApp number, and you may email at my this email address, or please subscribe my channel Abid Financials on the YouTube and visit my website abidfinancials.com. Thank you very much for watching this video. See you in our next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.